dozens of innovative projects, and as a result, the leadership in the list of the most visited pavilions at the Expo 2017 says a lot about the Swiss pavilion. The country can share its achievements in green technologies. Switzerland topped the 2016 rankings in the Global Innovation Index. Recently, the Confederation has become the fourth state in the world that has abandoned the nuclear power. This decision was adopted in a nationwide referendum. At the Expo 2017 in Astana, Switzerland participates under the Flower Power slogan. The Swiss Expo Commissioner Manuel Salchli told about the country's energy strategy in an exclusive interview to Kazakh TV channel.
The main idea is basically that all of us have an influence on what's happening to our landscape around us, to the beautiful nature. We invited people to enter the Swiss forest, which is like it is at the moment, very quiet. The trees are kind of dead. And only if the people take care of the beautiful nature that we're living in Kazakhstan and in Switzerland, only if we invest into new energies and leave fossil fuels and nuclear energy, the nature can actually survive. So that's the main concept. How do we talk to the people? It's four quite interactive thematic houses, as we call them. We have one house which invites the people into a Swiss cabin up in the Swiss mountains, and there we talk about solar energy, the two adventurers, Bertrand Piccard and Raphael Donjon, exploring the sky with solar-powered planes. We have a water house where people are invited to lie down for 10 minutes, listen to beautiful sound, and watch a movie about water management, all the threats that water can be, and possible solutions that we can find. The third house is a cooking show, as you have, may have seen it on TV. The people assist in the process of making a rösti, a typical Swiss potato dish, and along the process, they learn how to be energy efficient in their own private house. And last but not least, we have a station where we talk about a Swiss startup called CSEM that is continuously developing solar cells. And we show the visitors how a solar cell has changed from a very dark blue solar cell, as you may have seen it on the roofs of private houses or industrial buildings, to a small solar cell that you can actually wear on your close, and a solar cell which is able to produce enough energy to charge your mobile phone with. You know, it's a fantastic opportunity for Switzerland to be invited to the Expo here and in 2017, because in this year, in 2017, the Swiss people, they have voted in a public vote for a change of our energy strategy, meaning that by 2050, we will shut down all our nuclear power plants. We will increase the investment into the new energies, such as solar energy and water, hydropower. And we will try to increase the efficiency in our private homes, meaning that we will buy new fridges, new stoves that are very, very energy efficient, that consume less energy on a daily basis. And I must congratulate the Kazakh people. You know, normally if people visit an expo, they want to see as many pavilions as possible. So they would run through the pavilion in order to see the next one. But here, no, they take time. They sit down in our cabin, in our cooking show, in our Swiss Next Lab, where we have workshops. For example, they can make their own solar powered lamp, but it takes about half an hour. And whole families, they sit down, they take the time, and they take questions which occasionally our staff cannot even answer because they go so much into detail. So compliments to the Kazakh people actually visiting the Swiss Pavilion.
Switzerland has prepared a number of surprises. A large cultural program dedicated to the country's National Day is scheduled for August the 11th. The participation of Swiss President Doris Leuthard is expected.